You can't tell me how to feel about me and what I can accomplish. It's ridiculous to allow someone else to dictate how you feel about yourself. What's going on, family? It's your man, Jeff Kilgore, back again. You already know how we do it, business and mind all intertwined. And today, we're going to talk about how self-talk can change your life. You ready? Come on, let's do it. Now, I'm from an era where it was all about keeping it real. You know, I'm going to keep it a buck. I'm going to keep it 100. You know, everything was all about keeping it real. So you felt the need to always tell it like it is. You know, it is what it is. You know, I'm going to tell it like it is, and I don't care who don't like it, who don't understand it. It is what it is, right? It's the reality of the situation. So I'm going to tell it like it is, right? So because you may be from that era, and because you always want to keep it real, then you feel the need to always tell it like it is, right? But when it comes to self-talk, you already know how it is. Stop reiterating it to yourself. Stop, you know, regurgitating the past and talking about what happened in the past, the failed relationships, the failed financial opportunities, all of that stuff. You don't have to keep repeating it to yourself because you know what happened. You know what went on in your life. You don't have to keep saying those things to yourself. You don't have to keep thinking those things to yourself. See, you are the biggest influence on you. You. No one is more convincing to you than you. The buck stops with you. No one should be able to influence you more than you. Your decisions, your reasoning, everything that you think about, it ends with you. You are the one. You are the biggest influence on your entire life. What's happened is we have begun to let the outside world and past and previous experiences dictate how we feel about ourselves, what we can, what we cannot do, where we can and cannot go, the things that we can accomplish. We've let previous experiences and previous people dictate how we feel about ourselves, which is ridiculous. You can't tell me how to feel about me. You don't know what I'm capable of. You don't know all of the amazing things that I'm about to do in my life, all the amazing things that God has in store for me. You can't tell me how to feel about me and what I can accomplish. It's ridiculous to allow someone else to dictate how you feel about yourself. You are the biggest influence in your life. You, no one else, just you. Now, of course, we have other people that influenced our lives. Our parents influenced our lives. Even our environment influenced our lives. But the biggest influence on you is you. That's the highest form of influence, is you. You can determine how you feel about yourself. You can determine what you can accomplish and what you can't accomplish. So no matter your environment, no matter what type of situation your parents put you in, you are the biggest influence on yourself. Don't allow no one to tell you or make you think that they're a bigger influence on you than you are to yourself. Think about this. If I see a big red balloon, a big red shiny balloon, right? I see this balloon with my own eyes. I'm looking at it. I see this red balloon with my own eyes. And someone wants to convince me that this balloon is blue. That's ridiculous, right? I'm looking at it. This balloon is red. I'm seeing it with my own eyes. You can't convince me that this balloon is blue, period, because I see it. I'm the influence. I see that this balloon is red, right? I don't care who it is. It can be my mom. It can be my dad. It can be the Pope. It can be the pastor, the preacher, the president. I don't care who it is. You can't convince me that this balloon is blue when I'm looking at a red balloon, right? The buck stops with me. You're not going to convince me of that. And the only way that I would even possibly consider anything else is if you did some kind of magic trick or something and turned the balloon to blue. And then I would have to see it. And even then I would be like, okay, what did you do? Because I know for sure that balloon was red. I know it was red. So you did something. But notice what I said. Once I saw it is the only time I would even consider. Once I saw it, not you telling me that it's blue behind the curtain or whatever, not you saying that it was blue. I had to see it for myself to even consider anything else. And even then I'm skeptical because I know for sure it was red. You understand? You can't convince me otherwise. I'm the biggest influence on me. So think about how silly that sounds. You're gonna let somebody else tell you how to feel about you? You're gonna let a past circumstance, a previous experience tell you how to feel about yourself? That happened in the past. If I'm still alive and breathing, that means I got another crack at it. I got another bite at the apple. I got another shot at this. And it's about to happen. That's how you gotta talk to yourself. This is why I am affirmations are so powerful. Because you are regaining your power. You're regaining your authority over yourself. You're reaffirming how amazing you are as a person, right? And when you say, by the way, when you say your I am affirmations, don't make it only about money, right? Of course, yes, if money is something that you want, you want to say, I am wealthy. You want to say, I am rich. I am abundant. I am successful. I am opulent. All those things. Of course you want, if those are things that you want, if money is something that you want, of course you should say, and you should, right? But don't leave out the part about, I am an amazing person. I am an amazing friend. I'm a great dad. I'm a great mom. I'm an amazing wife. I'm an amazing husband. I'm energetic. I'm enthusiastic. I'm loving. I'm caring. Don't leave those things out. You are amazing. Don't forget about that. It's not all about money, because it would be a sad thing to just be a wealthy, rich jerk, right? So we want to be well-rounded. Money should be in your top five things that's on your list to have, but it should never be number one, right? So don't leave those things out when you're saying your I am affirmations. Don't leave out that you are an amazing person. Don't leave out that you're an amazing friend, you're loving, you're caring, all those things. And this is how talking to yourself can change your life, but you have to say the right things. You can change your life by convincing yourself, again, you are the biggest influence on you. No one else, nothing else. You're the biggest influence. So if you continuously tell yourself what you are and what you aspire to be, and you use it in the form of the present, I am this, I am that, then you can convince yourself. And what you do is begin to reprogram your subconscious mind. Your subconscious mind gets that hint and gets that programming. Okay, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am loving, I am caring, I am a great fan. Okay, then we're gonna start to produce the habits, the behavior that will result in those things. You're saying you're successful, then tomorrow morning when you wake up, we're gonna influence the habits that produce the behavior that's gonna make you successful. You see how this works? Your subconscious mind is behind the scenes running everything. And so things that you do without thinking about are the results of where you are right now. And so where you are right now are the results of whatever you've been doing every day up to this point. Now, if your subconscious mind gets the hint that, hey, wait a minute, I am successful, then we need to change our behavioral habits, the things that we're doing every day. So the next day when you wake up, all of a sudden you're doing things that a successful person would do. I am a millionaire. I am a millionaire. All of a sudden, you're waking up, you're doing things that a millionaire would do. This is how you change your life. You reaffirm, you regain your power, you regain your authority by telling yourself what you are, telling yourself what you're gonna be, because nothing, no one, nothing influences you more than you. Did you get any value out of that? I hope so. And if you did, squeeze that like button, like, comment, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. Especially subscribe. I've committed this year to upload Monday, Wednesday, and Friday all year. So I don't miss a beat. You don't miss a beat. And we can help each other. If you're still rocking with me at this point, you already know I appreciate you. Let's go.